pigeon ships there, maybe later. A giant crayfish. A lighthouse removed from some other point, brought here to the museum. This is the store for the VDL company and the house on the hill. And here's Joe Lyons' house where he was born Prime Minister of Australia for a few years, just below the nut. There's an aerial view of the nut and the, what was the homestead called?
Highfield.
Highfield up on the hill north of the beach. That's the aquarium along to the right. We're just down there now, near that. This is our campsite at Stanley. The sun is just peeping through it. About 7 or so up onto the nut in Joe Lyons cottage. Now sometimes you get these incredible evenings with the sun poking through. That's where we bought our fish and chips. And Joe Lyons' cottage is just behind there. And this is a waterfront that was blowing a gale last night from. Now it's dead calm. It's coming in from the east. The waves were breaking up over this footpath last night when we arrived. There's all the seaweed come up, and seaweed all along here.
Victoria Hats on. White
hats. That's the VDL store, which is now B&B, etc. And Joe Lyons is just behind it with a shingle roof.
And a square white house. It's got moss on the shingles. It's photos.
Sunny day, the wind farm. It's all coated with beeswax. Three 2 meter long blades. And it's 60 odd metres high, and there's several metres of thick concrete block underground here. All of this outline of white. Just picking up speed. There's Kate Grimm and the air monitoring station in through there in the mist. And panning around here, it's non-stop to Chile. And it's all the way around the world.
mainland's pollution, so we're getting Sydney or New South Wales. Incredibly, scientists have identified 10% more increase. I mean, we're in 2005 now. Heaven knows how much more increase that's got to.
Okay, well, that's good. You've got a couple of pamphlets there. Yeah. If you want to know anything more, there's an internet number on the bottom of the pamphlets, which will help.
This is Smithston. We just had our meat pie and lots of woolly shopping. And this is the Duck River, where they do lots of abalone harvesting. We're going to go south into the forests. That's the river going out to the harbour. This is the Arthur River that we were at the mouth of the other day. Then several log trucks coming along towards us, taking the forest out. And we're at this nice bridge, just wondering whether we might see one thunder across the bridge. In the rain this afternoon, tea time. What's it? Number three.
Or there, all those little bushes in the bottom of the
another
river
flooded river.
And
it's very brown and they're all with tannin, plus the logging, I'd expect. A good canoeing trip, or light water rafting. Probably go for miles. Yeah. Old traffic jam of them now. Going off to Guns. There's a little lookout, sumac. Lookout.
Sumac.
Looking, well, I think it's the Arthur River, but it could join into the sumac.
Sumac runs into it.
A lot of rivers run into the Arthur River, which comes right up from Savage River and way over to the east. This is looking north, I think. We're down at Lake Chisholm, which is in the middle of the myrtle rainforest. This is a drowned, blocked sinkhole in the dolomite. Could be pretty deep. It's very black. Looks like an acre or more in size. There's a beautiful walk down here in the wet, damp light. Very overcast, and the photos look really nice. Now I'll take some video on the walk back. Here's a little sinkhole that's 4 or 5 metres above the big one. It probably drains down into the rock. Yeah, it's a very old track. There's an old chair. Very large stumps from the old logging days. Little animal hideaway. I can see on the left through this buttress, right through. The trees are as big as in the sticks where the swamp gums, the regnans are, but these are the myrtles. So we've been led to believe, there's no discrete labelling anywhere. We might have to call it a day for rainforest video.
The Rapid River with a very dodgy looking bridge. Water's actually up to the big long supports underneath, having to duck under a little bit. Lovely clear dark brown water. Back under. Okay, now we can give it a go. Looks a bit windy, bendy and wavy.
Looks like a nice little swimming hole up there. All the foam on the bend, and as the usual, bit of rope hanging off a tree. Nearly tipped over in a culvert back there, reversing out. The whole bridge has slipped off the main log support there. There's the end of the log, and then it's been pushed out on this end. Yeah, just driving past, and this looks like a little natural ore, could have been created by the road. Frog Hollow. Little bonsai myrtle. He's not going to get much of a future. Maybe the sun has just come out for a few minutes as we got back to the Arthur River, 50 or 60 km upstream. river wise, probably 30 or 40 across country. Rivers still as big as ever. And some beautiful country. It'll be a nice drive now if the sun stays out. Large road cutting. The approach to the bridge. All for forestry. They say you can put your kayaks and rubber rafts in here and go down to the next bridge. Your fast little ride today. Nice drive now out of the forest, the forest reserve. And this is the typical rural grazing country, dairy country that we'll find all the way between here and north back to Stanley. A lot of areas are being planted with plantations of eucalypts. There's all the ewes. And over here we've got the milking sheds full of sparrows at the moment. Drive back through some beautiful sunlight in the afternoon, and these paper barks were brilliantly lit just a few seconds ago amongst all these cows. They're all going to come over and say hello. They must be expecting a titbit because they've all come over from a couple of hundred metres away. Poor dumb animals. Well, we got brilliant sunshine. It's nearly 7:30. So we thought we'd do a quick whiz up past the chairlift, catch this beautiful light up on the top of the nut. One of those perfect evenings again, like last night with the low sun, Godfrey's Beach. And there's Highfield that we drove past twice yesterday evening and spent a few hours looking over it. It feels much steeper than those angles would suggest. You just about get aerial views of the cemetery. Parks and Wildlife, we've got their ugly building, this is the base. Mightn't be able to see much of the town once we get